Today, on Golf Connoisseur, we have a very interesting personality with us, Sri Sathyanarayana Raju, who has carved a niche for himself in the world of Indian classical dance, Bharatnatyam. He has won several accolades and has been covered extensively in the media. Welcome to Golf Connoisseur, Sri Sathyanarayana Raju. Tell us something about your childhood and the kind of incidents that you know may have molded you into what you are today.
I come from agriculture family. My father was a farmer. We had a paddy fields and we used to grow grapes and guavas and all kinds of other vegetables. And so I was not exposed to art, exposed to all this art and culture and all. It's been in a village where I've been brought up and all. So childhood was like I did like any normal kid. I went to school and I was very naughty, like, you know, and I used to hit a lot of the friends, you know, a lot of complaints used to come to my mother.
Yeah.
That kind of naughty I was. Then I didn't know where to go and learn this dance and music. Somewhere I was attracted by music.
Yeah.
Those days in the radio it used to come.
Yeah.
Carnatic music,
yes,
in Bangalore station.
Yeah.
And when I was in fifth standard, my mother took me to the movie called Telugu movie, Siri Siri Muva, that was made in Hindi, Sargam,
yes.
Jayaprada,
yeah.
You must be knowing,
yes,
that. I saw that movie and I wanted to learn dance. Jayaprada was my role model. After watching her in the movie, I came home and I told you, like, we used to grow paddy and all. I used to go to paddy fields and dance, like, whatever, the movie song. I used to hum the song and I used to dance on my own.
Yeah.
Then I didn't have a guts to ask my parents to go and learn, because, you know, as a male, every family had that a man should go and work and earn the money, and that's it. You get married, have a kids and take care of your family. Not music and dance are not allowed for men, especially in my case.
Yeah.
In my community is very conservative. More than conservative, they're all business people.
Yeah.
They're all like hotels and farmers and business builders. So I'm an odd person in my whole community who's taken up this art.
Yeah.
Then after watching that movie, a lot of interest came for me to learn dance.
Who were your gurus who molded you into a beautiful classical dancer?
One fine day I was walking in my street. I heard a tattu called Tayar Tayar.
Yeah.
I walked inside the house
and
asked the ma'am, will you teach me a dance? She said, okay, come.
Yeah.
I asked her, what's the fees? She said, 20 rupees.
Yeah.
I didn't have that, I didn't know that samskara, that I should take fruits and do namaskar and all those puja, all those things. I went, I asked my mother to give me 20 bucks, she refused to give. Then I actually pulled her, she used to hold the money in her sari, those old days. I just pulled, I'm taking this 20 bucks, I'm learning dance.
Yeah.
I ran like this with 20 rupees and kept 20 bucks in front of. That's my first guru, Subhadra.
So how old were you at that time?
I was 18. Then I went, I gave her, it was in 83 I started actually.
Who were the ones who really influenced you and what?
My mother.
You can speak about her.
Yeah, and I told her, she happily said, okay, go and learn. That's why I took 20 bucks and left it in front of my teacher the day I started my dance. So then, unfortunately, my mother never saw my dance.
Okay.
83 I started, 84, 85 I was learning, and 85 I was supposed to give my first performance. My mother died of accident. So that was a big tragedy.
Yeah.
And I didn't know what to do. And
were you the only child?
No, we were seven at first.
Seven.
Yeah. It was a shock for me. I mean, I never thought, no, that we all live forever. I used to think whenever my mother used to go and attend somebody's death and all, I used to laugh at my mother. We always go and see and you cry, why do you cry? And she used to tell me, one day we also die. No, we all live forever, we will not die. Especially us, I used to tell her.
Yeah.
So when my mother died, it was a big,
I
didn't know what to do. And I was practicing for my dance first program and I had to stop. And 2 years I didn't dance. After that, I didn't go to class. Then I went. And my father was not very much interested in dancing. And like any other father, he wanted me to go and work. And I not studied also much.
Yeah, yeah,
after my 10th, I flunked in 10th grade also.
Yeah.
And after the 10th, I flunked and I went to do a small diploma course in 8 months course and 9 months course or 11, 12 months course you'll have, no?
Yes.
Those kind of diploma I did. Then I didn't, I had to go for, take a job.
Yeah.
I went for 3 months and I stopped. I said, no, I can't do.
Yeah.
I want to dance.
Yeah.
And my father was not allowing me and he refused to give me a fees.
Yeah.
Whenever I asked him fees, he used to get angry.
Yeah.
Why? Why are you learning dance? Then I had to lie him that I am going for sports. But this for 20 bucks, I had to lie, you know. Then I went to the Narmada Aunty. So there my proper training started. And of course, my first guru gave me a very good training. Whatever basics she's giving today, that only, you know, it's coming along with me. And of course, after you always go to the best, like what, how do you do PG and PhD,
yes,
no?
Yes.
It's like that in dance.
Yeah.
I went to Narmada Aunty and my life is settled there.
So what made you select Bharatnatyam?
So I didn't know anything about other form dance. There are so many. I only knew that there is a Bharatnatyam,
yeah,
and Carnatic scene, classical music and classical dance. That's it.
Yeah.
I didn't know anything about Kuchipudi and all those
other
things.
Forms.
In fact, I should tell you this incident when I was learning from my first guru, I met Maya Didi.
Yeah.
And then Maya Didi asked me to come to the institute to do the NIKC Institute, not
yes,
Institute of Kathak and Choreography, to
yeah,
do a ballet for exam ballets, to take a part in the diploma course exams
okay,
they do.
Yeah.
In exams they have a ballet,
yeah,
small little ballets. In that I was supposed to dance. And I went for a audition, she asked me to dance.
Yeah.
I did a Manduku Shabdam. She said, oh, you're a Kuchipudi dancer. Oh, Didi, I'm not a Kuchipudi dancer, I'm a Bharatnatyam dancer. She said, oh, you're doing Kuchipudi.
Yeah.
Then that evening I ran to my Subhadra Prabhu. I said, ma'am, what did you teach me? You have taught me only Kuchipudi. She said, both. I don't want both, I want to learn Bharatnatyam. See how illiterate I was.
Yeah.
I was literally illiterate. Whatever she taught me, I was thinking that is Bharatnatyam. Then I told her, I don't want Kuchipudi, I want to do only Bharatnatyam. Then she started teaching and then I met Ma Narmada Aunty. She was very strict. I said, I can't learn from this lady, my gosh.
Yeah.
After I went to class, she's like a kid.
Yeah.
She gave me wholeheartedly, she taught me and whatever I asked, whatever doubts I had in my mind, she made me very comfortable, you know, feeling. Of course, she took 2 years to take me very close to her. Those days, gurus were like that.
Yeah.
Not like our generation. We just take them and we teach them and okay, you go do whatever you want. Those days, gurus were like that. They used to see our seriousness in our, you know, a career. Whether this person is serious or not, is just coming for time pass. Karke. Then I didn't look back anything. Narmada Aunty
was everything. What were the strict principles that she based the dance on?
Oh, she was very strict when it comes to teaching and learning.
Yeah.
When she never got up and taught us actually. And of course she was very strict whenever she was teaching. After teaching one adu, if I change something, she used to get very angry. She said, no, nothing. You have to stick to the item, what I am teaching, the movement, all the adus, the basics, technique. Have to be very perfect, like what I am teaching. But sometimes she used to get up and show us. So beautifully she used to show. Very, you know, clear. And she's from Kittakpa village student. You know, she's a great master. He was. Professionally, it started, I should tell this about my father. Again, I had to beg for the, after going to Narmada Aunty, it was 100 rupees fees.
Yes.
You don't believe, every day I used to cry. Coming back home, I used to open the tap, water inside the bathroom, I used to sit and cry. So I should not let others to know that I'm crying. And while taking fees every month, I used to go and stand my father. I need 100 rupees. That time I started telling him I'm going for dance. And with great difficulty he used to make me wait more than half an hour and he used to give 100 rupees. Then I used to take my scooter and stop at one park. I used to cry and go to my Narmada Aunty's class. After entering Narmada Aunty's class, nothing, all those cry, all that, I used to forget, I used to dance. And I used to hide from my father. I used to wear dhoti. On the dhoti, I had to wear my pant and go remove my pant in the class and I had to dance and come again like that. So these are the difficulties. And male dancers. I saw male dancers. I was very happy.
Yeah.
So there are so many male dancers that I can take up this. And slowly after performing and somewhere in small corner, my name used to come in newspaper and something. I used to tell my father, see, my name is there today's paper. Then he was slowly, he was not even showing his happiness. He used to hide and say, okay, what is there, your name, he used to tell. And he used to tell, after I go, he used to call his friends and say, see, my son's name is there today. So slowly he started giving me little bit, day by day he started accepting me as a dancer. When I was 26, 27, it's a marriage age.
Yes.
And he used to force me. I told him frankly, see, I'm a dancer. I'm not earning one single rupee to take care of my wife. I can't rely on you. You are ready to take care of me and my wife. From your side, you are okay. But from my side, I can't. And personally, I feel when a girl marries a person, she comes with a lot of dreams that she'll be, you know, having a good life and lot of things, like, you know. So I didn't want to break her dreams, coming, marrying me. I'm a normal dancer. Those days, we didn't have social media to expose ourselves. Nobody was recommending us. Frankly speaking, no godfather, no godmother, those days. We had to push ourselves forcibly and we had to be really good with our presentation. We can't do altu faltu dance and make people happy.
Yeah.
Now people are accepting all kinds of dance.
Yes.
If I mix Bharatnatyam, some nonsense also, they say, wow, they say. Whoever came to watch us, and those days that CV, S.N. Chandrasekhar was there,
yeah,
a critic, a very senior person. He used to rip off like anything, you know, he used to dissect you like, you know, this is some flaws in my dance. But that scare was there for us, our generation.
Yeah.
Now generation, they don't have that.
Yes.
We were scared of critics. Many times I used to run to restroom from side wings if I see that S.N. Chandrasekhar sitting in front of the front row. Like that kind of scare and that kind of seriousness and that this thing was there for us that we have to be a perfect dancer, we have to know everything, we have to learn everything. So slowly my father started liking me and finally accepted. And when I did my first solo performance from Narmada Aunty's class, I didn't do Arangetram again, I should tell you. I didn't do all this Ranga Pravesha Arangetram. Narmada Aunty, she said, do just one solo program. I said, okay, I did it. I told my father, I'm doing this program, please come. That time my father was building one house, that's it. I entered with Pushpanjali, I see my father sitting in front seat with all the mistries and all those workers. He came with all those building workers along with him. Everybody was sitting down and small auditorium, Yavanika, that way, it was packed audience. I said, oh my God, my father is sitting, how will I dance? Then from that day onwards, he started liking. Then he accepted my thoughts also, like when I said I don't want to marry, and when he was fallen sick, he called me and said, okay, you made a good decision. Be careful and take care of yourself, he said. And he said, don't regret later and don't blame me that I didn't get you married and all. I told him, Dad, don't worry, I'll be like this. Today I'll be, every second I'll think of my dad especially, and of course my mother always, she's there with me, and every time, every program, after every program, there are small, this thing that my mother, no, I never saw my program. That's the only thing I feel when I went, go back home. After all the people praising you and giving lot of, you know, the happiness, when I go home, I feel that one small thing every program. Anyway, it's my, this thing, but I believe in a God a lot, He's somewhere and He's protecting me.
So at that time, what was the scenario in Bangalore as far as dance was concerned? Who were the dancers of your caliber, you know, who were making it big?
Oh, there are a lot. Kiran was big. Kiran and Sridhar Anuradha was big.
Yes.
And of course, Lakshmi Gopal Swami was big. Even though we were all colleagues in the Narmada, they were all big, like Nirupama, Sudha Bharatnatyam, those days. We were all good friends, but they were like flourishing. They have learned from childhood, not like me. I started very late, I said. I used to open my eyes and mouth like this and sit and watch them. I always respected all my colleagues and I never took it easy, like saying, oh, they are my friends. I always saw them as the best people and the best dance in them. I've learned so much from those people. I used to admire a lot Kiran's couples and Sridhar couples, yeah. And Nirupama and Lakshmi Gopal Swami. Of course, there was Rangashri. Rangashri was a very good dancer. And this Purnima Ashok, yeah. She was a wonderful dancer. And I used to watch, of course, Vani and Meera used to dance a lot. Yeah. Both the sisters.
Was there a healthy competition between the dancers or?
No, those days no competition at all. We, like Bangalore is, now I think with, I'm sorry to say again, youngsters, yeah, they have a lot of competition. Yes. We should never have competition in this art field, I feel, personally.
Yes.
That's how I've grown, watching the, and every program I used to go and watch. Those days I didn't have a vehicle also, I used to go in a bus on the way to JP Nagar to Malleshwaram 2-3 times, I used to go and come.
Yeah.
Coming and watching the Nupura festival, Nityanatyam, Lalita Srinivasan festival, those days were the best festivals, 10 days. She's the one guru who bought all the big names, Dhananjayan, Chitra,
yeah,
Visheshran,
yeah.
All those people, you name it, they've come and performed in her festival.
Okay.
Nobody had invited. After that, Kinkini started. Kinkini also got lot of great artists.
Yeah.
That's a big exposure for us, watching them. And again, I didn't have, my father didn't support to go and learn workshops, attending workshops. Because those days, 300 rupees workshop is too much for me to pay and learn. So somehow I missed all the Chitra Visheshan workshop and Kalanidhi Mami's Abhinaya workshop and Karna's workshop and Paduakka and all. I missed all those things those days. That's my personal problems.
So when you were not dancing, what were you really interested in? Because being a single person, you would have had more time.
I used to do gardening at home. I love gardening, I love plants. I used to do my own, I sit from morning till evening, I used to do reports and I used to collect plants, I used to do all those things, gardening and I used to do all household things, helping my sister-in-law, both my sister-in-laws.
So you don't stay alone, you stay with?
I used to, now I'm staying alone.
Yeah, yeah.
Those, till my father was there,
yeah.
We were all together, two brothers and sister-in-law, myself and my father. And our children have started growing, my grand nephews have started growing, they got married and I didn't want to, you know, my dancers, so much galata we do.
Yeah.
Every day musicians coming, every day practice is happening.
Yes.
So I said, okay, I'll stay. We are staying in the same premises, like one small this thing. I stay in next building.
Okay.
But still my dance galata is happening every day. And my sister-in-laws have a great support for me, like my family support now.
Support.
Especially my all sister, four sisters and two brothers. And two sister-in-laws and all nephews and nieces. That's what today I was just telling when I should wash their feet and drink that water, because this Panchali took a lot of effort. To 6 months I was working to collect the funds and everything.
Yeah.
All stood by me and they really helped me a lot. You know, first time I did something big production on my own from Samsung.
Tell us about that.
Yeah, this Panchali, actually I want to do Draupadi actually, name it as Draupadi. I want to do solo act actually. As a, I wanted, like I said, I respect the women a lot.
Yeah.
I really have a great regard. I wanted to do somewhere, my mind was telling me from last 5 years, I want to do Draupadi. And it didn't happen somehow. Then one fine day I thought I'll go and ask Bijesh, theatre person. Why not two? We'll mix theatre and Bharatnatyam together. Till now nobody has done that combo, especially male and female.
Yes.
So I went and approached her. She said, agreed easily. She said, what you do, what should I do? She asked me. I said, you be a sutradhari, I'll play Panchali. She said, you will do Draupadi? I said, yes, Draupadi I want to do. And she asked me, who will write the script? I said, no. Then I went and approached H.S. Ventesh Murthy.
He's
a big time writer in Karnataka. And he wrote a, he gave a caption, Panchali.
Yeah.
And he wrote a 38 pages of playwriting.
Oh.
I said, sir, what you have written, play, if not dance and music, theatre. Then again he wrote and gave me. It came out very well. B.J. Shivan directed play. And my dance portion I did. Every time when I explained many people that what my about new Panchali, they asked me, are you going to wear female costume? I said, no. Being a male dancer, I want to bring that women feeling
emotions out,
emotions and joy, everything. I want to bring it through my dance and Abhinaya. I don't want to wear, why should I wear female costume and dance? There are so many female dancers, they can do it.
Yeah.
Many people also got confused that I want to do a Bhamakala. Bhamakala.
So, if you could tell me more about the role of Rama and Ramayana, which you actually enacted all by yourself.
Yeah.
So how did that concept come about? And you've done it brilliantly. So tell us
concept
about
it. Concept actually was given by Usha Arke. You know her, no? I used to do a lot of items on Rama and other things. And she has seen me performing all kinds of varnams and other devanamas and padams and javalis. So she asked me, you're very good at characters. Why don't you put together and do one Rama Katha?
Yeah.
I said, okay, I will do it. Then we asked Vatsa to do music and we did it. There again we kept Rama as a center part. He's just he's a pillar there, that's it.
Yes.
Nothing to do with this Rama Katha. He's just standing there and Rama, that's it, an idol. Around him I played all the roles, Dasharatha and Kaike, Mantare, Hanuman, Guha. Again, lot of emotions there, you know. When Guha comes and Shabari comes specially, everybody knows about Shabari.
Yeah.
And this Mantare, especially in this episode, Mantare and Dasharatha is very strong, the emotions they have.
Even Kaike,
yeah.
That's very good.
Switching up the roles was literally, I should say, after I do Ramakatha, I need 1 week to relax, from take off from my mind and body, because first I do Mantare and go spoil Kaike's this thing.
Yeah.
I don't show Kaike person, I just see person, I don't become a Kaike, I'm still Mantara.
Yes.
I do all spoil her and tell her everything and I go and come as Dasharatha.
Yes.
From Mantara to Dasharatha coming is a big thing.
Yeah,
I have to become really calm and enter and see the Kaike and talk to her and he gets shocked there again.
Yeah.
Dasharatha will get, you know, like sending Rama to 14 years palace. That strongness. From Dasharatha to go to Rama to become that calmness is big task actually. The switching of the Abhinaya and your body, he's a Dhirodhata, Rama.
Yes.
The Dhirodhata taking that role is a really tough. You have to have it. And that's why I have to do a lot of breathing exercise and yoga. I do every day, of course, yoga. Especially for Ramakatha, I have to switch up the roles and more than switching up the role, like I said, the mind only has to be, taken from
tuned to that.
Tune. Otherwise, I can't come as a strong emotions. I can't bring it. It's a big, I don't say challenge. It's a very good feeling actually inside.
Yeah.
See, from childhood, I used to do a lot of games. I used to play those days outdoor games. Of course, you know, we used to play a lot. And from my 8th standard itself, I started doing yoga. I had a small health issue when I was in school. I had a nervous problem. I used to become a very weak and then person suggested me to do yoga. I started practicing yoga. And of course, yoga, I did it for some time and in between a lot of breaks. Like, you know, like when I was in 8th grade, it's like father used to force me to take yoga and come back home. Then later I took it seriously. And I do a lot of gymming and all. I go for a walk and jogging I don't do now. And every dancer should do a yoga and breathing exercise.
Yes.
That's very, very important. Not only dancer, every human being should do a yoga. Now, Mr. Modi has made yoga day.
So,
people are misusing it that.
Yeah.
I'm sorry to say, they're just making use of that yoga day, like on social media that they're becoming, you know.
Yeah.
They're not using a real yoga as a yoga.
Yes.
But
and
yoga gives you a lot of strength to do.
Yeah.
You should do, I do only Surya Namaskara. I do 108 Surya Namaskaram. And the Kapalabhati I do for 500. That's only 2 techniques I use. So that gives me a lot of strength. Especially when I do my regular varnams and all. It's like 45 to 1 hour I do.
Yeah.
A strong Tanjur quartet varnam, you need a lot of strength. So you have to do a fitness exercise for dancers. It's must and should. They should do. Yeah,
what is the sort of diet that you follow?
Diet as such, only later now I think I'm a little bit dieting. I stopped taking white sugar.
Mm-hmm.
I don't touch white sugar now from last almost 8 months now, that's it. Then I eat all kinds of food. I can, I do workout, that's it.
Yes.
In between, I mean, again this is a phobia now, to follow this diet, that, this, and listening to people. I did. I said nothing good. I eat nicely rice and I do ragi.
Yeah.
You know, then I eat a lot of vegetables. I'm a vegetarian now. I become vegetarian.
Yeah.
I was non-vegetarian. Yeah. I gave up long back. Audience are difficult, like in Bangalore we get good audience.
Yes.
In Chennai, very rarely you get only Ulu Sankh. When we did Natyarangam Festival,
yes,
they did the subjects, they have given different subjects.
Yes.
For me and Lakshmi Gopal, they had given Mysore Warriors.
Yes.
So that time we had good audience because the subject was so strong.
Yes.
If it is regular Margam and regular Margam, this what Margila Festival and all. How people attend all the sabhas? There are 10 sabhas presenting 10 good dancers. And only if Chennai people are dancing, their own friends and their relatives go. Bangalore, if I go, where will my relatives and friends come from all the way there? Even though I have few friends in Chennai, they will come. But here it's not like that. If you are doing 3 good shows in Bangalore, all 3 halls will be good. Some art lovers will be there. Not 10, you will leave dancers and musicians. But good art lovers will be coming and watching the program.
Yeah.
Oh, music is very, very, very important. You know, you can't do anything without them. Musicians has to be there, and one has to learn music. Every dancer must learn music.
So how do you select them?
Yeah, by like how do you select music?
Could you name some, for example?
For me, I feel Vatsa is the best today.
Yes,
and those days, Janvi Jayaprakash was the best singer, female singer. She was the best in Karnataka.
Yeah.
And after that, male singer, I came across only with Shri Vatsa.
Yeah.
He is the best. And actually, with both of them, Janvi Jayaprakash, she's no more now, of course, a great lady. She and only Vatsa, both of them, they both watch the dancers and they catch the pulses of the dancers and they go along with them singing. They don't just blindly like this, they won't sing.
Yeah.
They just watch you move.
Yeah, yeah.
Every
so they are in sync completely.
They sing. And especially now for my Ramakatha and all, my God, my hats off to Shri Vatsa, and with his emotions, you know, I am getting a lot of abhinaya. First of all, I tell youngsters to just practice every day and respect your teacher. That's it. Don't go behind fame and name. Fame and name will come only when you are really good from heart. And that shows in everybody's dance, whether you're dancing from your soul or just from outer this thing. I don't think they should go have enmity in all these things. They should not dislike each other. They should like each other, and they should, especially youngsters, should go and watch each other's program. Nowadays, you don't see many youngsters coming and watching dance. They say, "What is there in his dance? What is there in her dance?" That kind of attitude I've seen, literally I've seen, but I just keep quiet. I don't want to correct them. Who am I to correct? If I'm very really close to my heart, somebody, I just tell them on their face. Otherwise, I don't tell them. I don't think they should have this competition with enemy. They should have a strong practice, strong riyas they should do, that's it, end of the day. There are aggressive parents, but in my samsuti I have not given the chance to them, because I am a very frankly spoken person.
Yeah.
I tell them, yes, your daughter can learn, your son can learn, and don't expect me to do their arangetram and so on several days, and don't expect me to send them for competition, and don't ask me for TV shows and all. I'll teach them. I'll groom them, I'll make them an artist, I don't make them a dancer.
Yes.
So that they agree. Because this is depends upon us only. We should speak to the parents and you should give them what you have. You should not give them a colorful hopes to colorful hopes to parents especially and children also. You should tell them what is the dance.
Reality.
So I tell them. Why I don't do arangetram? Because my class has all kinds of classes.
Yeah.
From lower middle class to high class people comes.
Yeah, yeah.
If this person does arangetram and spend a lot of money, this person will feel
she doesn't have the capability.
She doesn't have capable now. They will go borrow money and do it. That I don't. Now it's very easy to borrow money.
Yes, yes.
So this person will go take loan, private loan or something, they spend money and they will do it. And what is the next
that child will go for something else, mm-hmm. she goes for some engineering,
yeah.
something she does. If she don't continue dance.
Yeah.
All these things I talk to the parents. All the values I talk to them. Money value and all those things. I don't talk to one-on-one at all. I'm not a person who will talk one. Maybe people say, this is the situation. What do you want to do? Ask them. And I ask in front of the parents with kids, are you serious about your dance? Are you learning because your parents are bringing? Are you learning because just Sathya sir is a dancer? You've seen him in TV and YouTube? Or you're fascinated by somebody else? I have to ask these questions. The children can be very truthful, they'll say, no. Many people come with very frank opinion. No, my mom wants me to dance, they say. My dad wants me to dance. I am not interested. And I like that, those kids.
Yeah.
Really, I like that.
Yeah.
The frankness. Now it's becoming very Western in India. They're very open children. They know what they want. Our days, I didn't think.
Yeah.
Maybe in your days also,
yeah.
you must
yeah,
be. You were not so open
yeah.
to the
yeah.
parents
yes.
and this thing. You have to hope like
yeah.
that.
Yeah.
Whatever they say, whatever they ask you
yes.
to study, be studying.
Yes.
Now children are open like that. And especially Arangetram, no, I don't
yeah.
force, I don't do it.
Yeah.
And nowadays, now from last 2 years, some of the parents, they said, sir, for our family sake, we want to do one solo show. Can you please? I said, okay, I do. I did it. I didn't do Arangetram. I called it my program, Natya Sandhya.
Yeah.
Evening of Bharatnatyam.
Yeah.
So that Natya Sandhya, I'm continuing with my students. They're very happy with it. I don't want to spoil parents' feelings
yeah.
and their hard work, money. And
so what is your last sort of a message to your students or aspiring dancers?
Aspiring dancers, first of all, respect your guru and parents and focus on whatever you're doing. The focus will show you a path wherever you have to go. And if you don't have focus, you can't reach any goal. It need not be a dance only. Whatever your career, if you're doing engineering, focus there.
Yeah.
But for me, I'm a dancer, I'm a very selfish person. I say, don't go to engineering or medicine, just dance. My message is that, that's it, riyas.
Thank you so much for being with us today on Gulf for us. This is Sathyanarayana Raju for you.